What's going on, boys? In today's video, I am going to be doing deadlifts, bent over rows, and bicep curls. Before I start the video, I just wanted to address something that I've noticed. So I've been on the carnivore diet now for 5 days. I also did it for 5 days 2 weeks ago, but I had to stop because I went away. I wouldn't have had access to just meat. But this week, back on it, I'm gonna be doing it for a month. And I wanted to say, my jaw was hurting. When I woke up this morning, yesterday I had 3 steaks and I've been eating at least 2 steaks a day. My jaw was hurting and I was thinking, what's going on? Why is my jaw hurting? My teeth, even my teeth were feeling a little bit sore, as if I've been overusing them. So I looked at a picture of myself, an old picture of myself, and I thought, I look a bit different. I looked at myself in the mirror and I thought, what the fuck is going on with my face? Boys, I'm not joking. My jaw is like thickening up around the outside. And it feels a bit like, I feel it. I feel this. I have not felt this ever. I've never felt there actually be just something here. It feels like a lump almost here. I've never felt that before. It feels fucking, it feels good. It feels really good. Just a benefit of the carnivore diet that I've never thought about. I don't think anyone's ever noticed that before. You just thicken your jaw up because you're chewing. I cook my steaks rare. So when I'm slicing through that, there's still blood seeping out of it. Okay? So I'm chewing a whole fucking load. Okay, I'm chewing a lot. And it's delicious. And my jaw, obviously, as a consequence of that, is thickening up. And boys, I have to say, feels terrific. just the benefit of the carnivore diet you've probably never heard of. All right, nice one. Let's get on with the video. That made no difference. That made no difference. I guess it's because it's not really the heavy weight. It's not 60. What I'll do, I love the weight. I'll try and get up to 200 using the belt, see what it feels like. No, I'll try again without that. There's that belt. I gave it a go with the belt, my friends. Wasn't feeling it. Doesn't jive with me. I used to use the belt a lot. The first time I got 200 kg, I believe I was using the belt. But nowadays, it doesn't benefit me at all. Alright boys, I got 180 kg twice. Now I failed 190 kg twice. So I knocked it back down to 180. I'll get the third set, then I move on to rows. Nice. What I'm aiming to do with the deadlifts, boys, is that we all seen I've got 200 kg, I've got 240, I've got whatever. What I'm aiming to do now is I'm not deadlifting as much, evidently. I haven't deadlifted in a long time. Before doing this start of training, I'm going to have, I've been getting evidently weaker. So what I'm aiming to do is lift a heavier amount of weight than I did the week before, every time. So let's say today, for instance, I got 180 kilograms three times. Next week, I'm going to try and get 185 kilograms three times, or 190 kilograms once and then 180 kilograms twice. Of course, I'll try 190 three times. If I don't manage to get it once, I'll knock it down to 185 and I'll get 185 three times. If I don't manage to get 185 three times, I'm at least going to get it once and then I'll get 180 twice. So I'm going to be aiming to improve every time I deadlift, but I'm going to be deadlifting with far less frequency. The reason being is that when I was doing my deadlifts previously and I was doing that program that I always testify about, whereby you deadlift every day, you get stronger every day. Doing that works, it worked, but it absolutely fries your body. Like, I've done that many times and it has just written me off for so long, because you're deadlifting every day, you're going up in weights, or sorry, going up in repetitions every day, you're taxing your body more and more and more, it compounds, you get to the end of the week, you hit your PB, and then you are just fried then for the week. So it works if you're going for a personal best, but it really isn't possible to do if you're also training, let's say, jiu-jitsu, you're also doing cycling, you're also doing regular weightlifting, things like that. So yeah, I'm not going to do that at the moment. I'm going to keep going with this style of training just for a few months, see if it works, see if it has any benefits for me. And then, you know, when it comes back to winter and I start bulking, deliberately eating loads of food and gaining weight, then I'll switch back across to trying to, you know, boost up the lifts. Yeah, but that won't be for a while. Anyway, just finished deadlifts now, so I'm gonna go do some bent over rows, just a couple of sets. Then I'll finish off with a couple of sets of bicep curls. Nice one, boys. Absolutely fried. Now, just some nice bicep curls. Good way to finish the session, then I'm off. All right, let's get it. All right, boys, so what I'm gonna do is, since my grip is evidently a weakness of mine, I'm gonna be improving that in this bicep session. So, very simple. I'm gonna do some normal curls, some reverse curls, and then I'm gonna come up here, I'm gonna grab 10 kilograms by the sides like this, and I'm gonna hold them for as long as I can. Okay? That's been the session. Maybe I'll put some shoes on. No, I'm fine. I have a slide time. I'm fine. Got to mention as well, once I fail holding on, I'll finish off with some more curls. All right, boys, I'm currently recording this on my second phone because my first phone, very annoyingly, let me just close it up, ran out of storage. Did it get it, actually? Hold on. No, it didn't. Okay, so I recorded a video on my, it kind of got it. I recorded a video on my phone whereby I did, I'll put it on. I'll put it on now. But yeah, I pretty much did bicep curls and then I did reverse curl. Actually, I won't put it on because it's not really anything. You can barely, just some explaining what I'm going to do. I did bicep curls, like that. My string is soaked, by the way, soaking wet, so I had to hang it up. I did bicep curls, then I did reverse curls, then I did like a grip exercise whereby I just held on to the 10 kg plates like this, and then I did that, so I was holding on to them for maybe a minute 30, then I failed, dropped them, went back over there, did 10 more reverse curls, 10 more bicep curls, and then here I am. And I'm not going to put the video on of me doing it because you won't be able to actually see it, but you'll pretty much just see me explaining what I'm going to do. So let's see. Here we go. There's the 10 kgs. Did I capture it? I captured me doing the bicep curls. Then, oh, yeah, then I captured me swapping it around to do the reverse curls, and then it ends. Yeah, because my storage is full. So, yeah. Anyway, boys, I just wanted to let you know, I did do biceps, smashed it. I know you guys trust me anyway, and I say I do it, but smashed it, very happy with it, massive session. Got a big, nice thick pump. Sweating loads, I'm gonna go for a shower now. And yeah, so I've got to say, thank you very much for watching, boys. I'll see you all tomorrow. Hasta mañana, mis gringos. Adios.